The next question, again, goes to Yellowknife Center candidates, Arlene Hache and Robert Hawkins. And the Chamber's question is this. During the past couple of years, we've seen a dramatic decline in business activity in the downtown core. While there are many variables at play as to why a business relocates to the old Airport Road area or closes their doors, the main reason most retailers list for leaving the downtown is the social problems that they are faced with as a business. Increased incidences of vandalism, assault, theft, garbage, and human waste caused primarily by people under the influence of various substances are driving residents and businesses from the downtown core and hurting the city. What are you committed to do to deal with this growing problem? And we'll begin with Arlene Hache of Yellowknife Center.
Thanks very much for the question. It was interesting because I went to Sisson School today and children identified the very same problem. In that they were afraid to be downtown. So I've worked in that field for almost 20 years, and I found that you really need a multi-layered approach that addresses the social determinants of health, such as family breakdown, mental illness, and addictions. The big challenge that we face is that the GNWT is only willing to put a Band-Aid on a gaping wound. And as a result of that, there's been no progress in terms of really addressing what in the end is trauma-related impacts from residential school, from violence in the communities, and from addictions. So there are solutions that we've been trying to implement, and we have not been successful in getting the GNWT as a partner, or a meaningful partner. One is removing the silos that prevent people from getting assistance. And that would be, it makes it difficult for individuals and families to access resources. The other thing we would like to do is really facilitate a planning process for people with mental health and addictions issues where they predetermine what plan they want in place prior to the time when they get into trouble. We want a stronger RCMP foot presence in the city. We want to have stronger mental health.
We're going to have to leave things there. Thank you. And our second candidate for Yellowknife Center, Robert Hawkins.
Thank you, Jocelyn. This is a problem that I've been working on for 8 years, and in the last 4 years, I've been able to get some headway on this particular problem. And I'd like to also point out this is a problem in the city of Edmonton that they had suffered for many years, and I think their one good solution to look towards to say, how did you do this and how did you solve some of the problem? And how they addressed this was they brought investment back into their downtown to show that it is a good place to work and it is a good place to live. And those are just the beginning, or I should say, stepping stones part of the solution. Downtown needed a day shelter. That was one of the things businesses told me when I ran for re-election in 2007. It was something I worked on right away, and I was thankful the Department of Health and Social Services felt it necessary and certainly worthy of that investment. But unfortunately, I always felt that they did only phase one of what I would call a phase two process. They established an opportunity for people to go during the day, but they don't, in my view, didn't quite staff it in the way that I had hoped. I'm looking forward to what I would call phase two, where we'll have social workers there helping transition people's addictions and ills into solutions. Even if it means that every day they have to keep asking the same people the same types of questions, eventually people are going to want to be picked up and provided new opportunities. Now, people are working there now and they are providing a service, but I think we need a hard and honest look at housing needs, employment needs, and solutions to that. I agree we need public ordering rules requested by the City of Yellowknife, and certainly a stronger RCMP presence is necessary. There's a lot more to say, but time is short. Thank you.
Right. Thank you. And we'll also have our candidate for Yellowknife South weigh in on this question, Bob McLeod.
Thank you very much. And I agree this is getting to be a serious problem, and I think in order to resolve the problem, you have to understand the underlying cause, and I think there's work been done to try to determine where do the people, homeless people that are on the street, where do they come from? I think they come from a number of different places, and I remember living in Edmonton when they were trying to reduce their amount of money they're spending on welfare, and they would give people a bus ticket out of town or they would try to get rid of the problem that way. And I thought about it, but I don't think that's the answer here in Yellowknife. I think that we need to continue the path that we started. I think we need to provide more support to the homeless coalition. I think we need to work at it from a number of different levels. I think for those people that can get off the street, those people that just need a helping hand, perhaps some education, some housing, some opportunities for employment, I think those are the easiest one to deal with. The other ones that have mental health addiction issues is much more difficult, and also the hard to house. So we have to approach it from a number of different ways. We need to work together. We need to help.
All right. Thank you. Thank you.